Yo, what's up? This is St. Joe, soundsofgear.com. Today, checking out Vintage Key Slice Machine by Samplephonics. Now, it's a huge collection of, you know, organ, piano, synth, EP type of loops, but it's in their custom slice machine interface for contact. And what that allows you to do is go in and kind of slice up the loops, remix them, reverse them, pitch them up, pitch them down, do a lot of different stuff with the slices inside of the contact interface. Now, you do need the full version of contact to use it. And what they did on this one, if you've seen a previous slice machine video I did, this one actually allows you to go in and adjust the slices yourself. So it's really cool. Definitely want to show you around the interface and, of course, listen to what it sounds like. So let's check it out. All right, so here's the slice machine interface. Pretty straightforward. Got your add slice button, remove slice. There's your waveform, different views. So there's bars 3 through 4, 1 through 2, and you can actually just put it on 2 bars if you want, or all 4. You got your playback mode, which is loop, and then one shot, tempo, sync, on and off, quantized settings. Then here's where you can choose your different slices. So if I had a bunch of slices, I could choose them, and then the different parameters I want to adjust: pitch, pan, filter, bit crush, reverb, all that different stuff. You can do the same thing directly over here in this little matrix here as well, and then you have the reverse option right there. So this is really cool. What I want to do, there's a lot of different types of loops in here. I'm gonna just go through a few from each category, but the main thing I want to show you is how you can add your slices. So let's say we have this one pulled up right now. Let's say we want to add slice. I'll add a slice right here, and as you can see, I can just pull it right down there, maybe add another one here. So you can see it's really quick to go in and just add the slices that you want where you want them, and you can move them after the fact as well. So I'll just add one more because I see a few different, this is pretty percussive, or, you know, a lot of different chords. So I can go in and now, and the good thing about this, having this inside of Kontakt, is you can turn on the tempo sync. So now your slices are going to sync to your tempo, automatic time stretching, really, really cool. So I've been a fan of the slice machine interface, but one thing I wanted in the original or the first version was I wish we could go in and change our slices, and you can see they updated that. So that's really cool. And of course, you can manipulate each individual slice. So let's say on that slice, I want it to be, maybe I want to reverse it, and I can mess with the cutoff. So you can see if I play it, and add delays, all that different stuff. So there's a lot of stuff in here, like 492, I think, loops. So I'm gonna just go through a few from each category. Slice it up real quick, wherever you want. Like I said, just depends on how you want it. That one, let's say maybe you want a slice right there, and maybe one right there. So the sounds themselves sound good, but again, really flexible having that inside of Kontakt. You can see all the content in there, man. There's so much in there. Let's pull up one of these, and then we'll move to the next one. So definitely has that nice, funky, vintage sound to it. So we'll put one there, and we'll put another one there. Now, the multis are going to be more like construction kits. They're going to have multiple sounds that work together. So let's say we pull this one up. You can see there's even some strings in this one. So you can go through, chop it up, just add a few slices. And one thing about, you know, working with the 4 bars is, let's say you get your slices how you want here. What you could do is go over, you know, to the other 2 bars and kind of make similar slices, but maybe you want them to be reversed or add some delay, different stuff. So it just gives you some flexible ways of working with it. So you can see, man, just so quick to go in and add your different slices. That one's a little better, so maybe something like right there. So you can see the idea. Again, maybe one over here, and let's do a whirly. We'll just add a slice real quick there, and maybe another one here, so you can get the idea. And let's say maybe on this one, maybe we want to have a little bit of delay or something, so turn up my delay. You can see how you can just mess with each individual slice, man. Like I said, really, really flexible and tons of content in here. There's a bunch of different organs. Put it right there. So you get the idea. You can see how quick it is. Like I said, you know, their original slice machine had the slices in there already. You could do all this stuff, but you couldn't really change the slices. And now they've updated it to where you can actually go in and change the slices and interface, which, again, I think it just makes it a lot more powerful, in my opinion, and a lot more fun to play with, because you can go in and slice it however you want. So let's do this one, put it right there. Then we'll do another one, maybe there, and do one more, maybe right there. So pianos, EPs, organs, clavinets, even strings and synths, tons of different sounds in there. So maybe right there. So yeah, you get the idea. Like I said, I can go in, maybe I want to filter on this one, so I'll just mess with the filter there. Kind of turn it down a little bit too low, but you get the idea. You can just adjust it for the different slices. And you can do whatever. You can pan, you can mess with the pitch on the individual slices, pretty much whatever you want to do right here really quick. So again, just definitely makes working with these slices flexible, working with these loops flexible, because of course you still got the samples themselves, but being able to go in here and mess with the different slices and then, you know, tweak each individual chop how you want it is pretty cool. So again, however they went in and programmed it so you can adjust those slices is really cool. You can't do the start point, which on some of them you may want to do that, which would, you know, that would definitely be cool. But the fact that they figured out how to program it and make it so we can adjust our own slices directly in the interface, man, is just some really good programming in my opinion. And again, it just makes it much more powerful to work with these loops in this way. Right there, really quick, just coming up with ideas, just messing with the slices. See, and then you got some synths in there. Let's check out a few of those. So on this one, I'm gonna add a few slices, maybe one there and another one here, then I'll do another one right there. So you get the idea there. Again, and it's really quick just to go in there and find where you want to slice things. So, and moving them around, it's not really clunky. It's really straightforward. Let's see, maybe two more. So you can see, and then maybe one more just to give you a feel for it. But you can see all these, like I said, there's like I want to say it's 492. I think that's what it said. 492 different chops. So, I mean, different loops. So, definitely a lot to work with, especially the way you get to go in here and chop it up yourself and just kind of mess with the different chops and slices and effects and stuff. So, yeah, so you get the idea, man. Pretty straightforward, really, really great sounding samples, but this interface really takes it to the next level. When I first saw the Slice Machine interface, I think it was on a drum library, and I was like, man, this is really cool being able to go in and mess with the chops and stuff like that, but I would like to be able to actually add my own slices or just move the slices around, and I don't know how they programmed it, but they did it, and now you can go in and add your own chops, so it really brings a lot of flexibility to the loop library, and again, like I said, the samples sound good on their own, so having that power behind the contact interface really takes it to the next level. Overall, man, I give it a 4 out of 5 subs. I think it's a great library. I hope they start doing more loops and samples in this format because it really just gives you a lot of flexibility being able to add your own slices in contact and still get that benefit of the real-time time stretch, you know, sync and tempo, and then all the different ways you can manipulate each chop. So remember, you can get this directly from the Samplephonics website. You can see right there, if you click over there, it's $68.13, or you can just get the Wave version, the Apple Loop version, so it depends on what you're looking for. Now, if you get the Slice Machine version, it does require the full version of Kontakt. It doesn't work in the Kontakt player. So let me know what you think. Like, comment, subscribe, share, all that good stuff. Again, this is St. Joe, soundsandgear.com, checking out Vintage Key Slice Machine from Samplephonics. 4 out of 5 subs. Let me know what you think below. I'll see y'all later. Peace.